that refreshing new.
I should look at the camera even though I keep looking down at the screen. So I'll look at the camera.
My name is Judy Sigler, and I'm a mom and a school counselor from Nebraska. And thanks to Quirky, I can now add inventor to my title.
Hi, I am Sandy Lair. I live in Cleveland. I am in my late 30s. Currently, I'm a stay-at-home mom. Formerly, I was an investor relations officer.
Hi, my name is Peter Probart. I'm in my early 40s. I live in England with my wife and two kids. And for my day job, I'm a business development manager with Cisco. But by night, in my own time, I enjoy the joys of crowdsourcing. Crowdsourcing for me offers three opportunities. The first one is the financial gain one could get from having your idea bubbled up by the community through one of the invention websites like Quirky or GeniusCrowds and turned into a product to give you and your family security and money.
So I watched the site for a few days and all of a sudden I thought, oh, what about that coffee spoon idea that I had? And so I immediately put together a presentation and uploaded the pictures to the Quirky site. They take ideas once a week. And so I waited a few days. I kind of had doubts after I uploaded it. I thought, oh gosh, why am I doing this?
There's 30 days. I would say the first week you raise a ton of money and then nothing happens for a long time.
And I thought, you know what? What do I have to lose? And then the product went live. Everybody started to comment on it and vote and whatnot.
It was, I would say, not impossible because we succeeded fundraising my project, but by trying to pitch to people, I am doing a student film, here's my idea. Like, I was able to get plenty of people who loved the idea, but didn't understand necessarily why they needed to put their own money into it.
At the end of the week, when the clock ran out of time and it was time to choose the product for that week, they did choose the Mugster.
The second is the buzz you get from seeing the feedback, the reactions from the community, the crowd themselves, those who like your idea, comment and expand upon it. What a feeling that is.
The community helps develop how it's going to look, what the name is going to be, a tagline, all of those sorts of things.
The tools and the resources of Kickstarter are amazing, but it's like anything in anywhere. It's just not like a free money pit. It's definitely something that you have to like earn and put forward a lot of effort into.
It's fun. You get to be creative. I just had my first invention idea selected by GeniusCrowds this past Friday, so I'm very excited about that. I make a little money up front, and hopefully I'll make a lot more down the road.
And the third one is the existentialist part. The fact that your idea can be turned into a product that will be sold, put on the shelf, for other people to see. You can turn to your friends and family and say, I did that. That was my idea, developed by the crowd. And there's other opportunities around crowdsourcing for other businesses.
So we as a community, came together and came up. I know it's this little tiny spoon, but I was amazed at all the stuff that went into just designing a little bitty spoon. And I think it turned out fantastic. I'm so happy with it. I'm so excited that it's going to be on HSN.
Quirky manufactures the products. Their products can be found in retail stores already. They're located in Bed Bath & Beyond, and they're also pitching their products on HSN. So you'll see them on HSN, I believe, on April 28th.
It taught me a lot. It was successful, which was good for a learning experience. I've had a lot of learning experiences where you just fail and then you learn. So I got to succeed, but also learn a lot of important lessons about how to effectively use this tool. Microfunding kind of provides this sense of like anyone, anywhere who likes a sort of idea or a creative project can donate even small amounts of money, and it all kind of pools together to like create something big.
Crowdsourcing is it's just a great way to be creative, and I just see it as a growing thing. I feel that many businesses are really going to participate in it.
I happened upon the Quirky site and just fell in love immediately and knew right away I want to be a part of this.
What a fantastic thing.